hello again. So happy you could join me on this beautiful day. Oh, it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. I'd like to start out by thanking all my viewers and subscribers. I really do appreciate it. I always try to get back with you as soon as I possibly can. What we got today is my usual pre-stretched canvas 16 by 20. I spray painted it with your local hardware spray paint to get different tones and hues on here. Then I loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid clear. That's going to help the oils go on a lot smoother. And you'll notice that if you missed a spot, the oils are dragging that spot there. So that's where I'm at so far. And any colors and any information you'll need to paint along with me will come across the screen right about here, like always. Today I thought maybe we'd do a glacier, maybe a pond, evergreen trees, maybe some flowers. I've been doing more flowers. It adds more color. I'm trying to brighten up the paintings. And if you follow along with me, you'll probably notice that. So that's where I'm at so far. So let's get started with a little fan brush. And we'll make a spot here. Gonna load up with liquid white. Gonna load us. Maybe have a sunrise here, a sunset, some light source just before the glacier, maybe. Maybe. Just like that. A little bit on there. I'm going to take this real soft blender brush and blend this in. Just get that look. A little bit of white just before the mountain. Tell you what, let's add some pink in there, get some color. Like I said, I'm going to make it get some pink and white. Cleaning a brush off with odorless paint thinner, that's always a good thing to do. And to use more white. Blender brush again. Want to leave that brighter white in there. Come into the pink again, pinky sky. Kind of load that all the way up. Whatever you think. Have it go all the way into the sky. into nowhere. Get that fan brush off again, or we can just get the white in there. Just get that white. Bring that blender brush. Where we're just getting that sharp whiteness. Who knows, maybe that just goes off like that. Now we can come in to a little bit of pink and purple. Some clouds. Darker pinks, purple. Because right around in that area, the clouds are going to be this color. Maybe it goes right across the sunset or the sunrise. Just doing circular motions. Circular motions. Come in with this blender brush and tap this. Circular motions. Get some of that purple pink color sky going. All the way down. That blender brush off. Not the excess. Try to get all that pink out of there. Now we'll come in to the palette knife. Maybe we'll do some blue mountains. A blue, darker blue. Blue with a little bit of purple in it. Get a little roll of paint right across the edge here. And we'll come in and we'll put our mountain. Right there. Make little ledges and cliffs and whatever you think. Keep loading up some more paint. like that off in the distance. Let's see. Come into this brush here that we use for the liquid clear. And we'll blend this down. Just how we want the mountain to be. Can have all kinds of different things happening in here. Pulling all kinds of different ways. Clean that brush off. Now we'll come in some white with the palette knife for the snow. We'll roll the paint right across. Since our light source is here, all I'm doing is tapping it. Let it go all the way off. Here there's some dead on that corner. A little bit more. Take the other edge, the smaller edge there, to get into this corner right here. This comes right across. All kinds of things happening there. Now we'll take some blue shadow color. Leave it marbly, just like that. Kinds of different rock formations. Looks pretty good. Come into the blender brush and tap this. I'm going to pay close attention to the lay of the land and come down and get that misty right down to the foot of the mountain. Also blends that white in nice. Gives you that misty, that mistiness at the foot of the mountain. Just keep tapping it. That brush off again. step back. Maybe we can put a bird in there. Silhouette of a bald eagle. You can make it whatever you want. Sometimes the bald eagle will be flying. Will be flying alone, right over the mountain. They usually fly by themselves. That's why you only see one. Now we'll come in here. And do some trees. Using liquid clear. The fan brush, this big one. And we'll come into some blue color. Darker blue off in the distance. Gonna go to a smaller brush. Smaller fan brush. Load it up the same way. Just like that. Come in and tap. Tap some. Like that. Want to leave the distance in between and have that misty, foggy look. Between them. Each layer. Who knows what's going on over here? this one go right off the canvas on this side. Go higher up. Then you come in and shadow that up. Tap it. Mist it. All the way. That gives you another level. Another layer. Another layer. Just like that. Man. Like we did the top row. It's like we did the top area of the mountain. The evergreen trees. Some will be darker, some will be lighter. Just like we did the other one. Just like we did the one behind us. Come in, tap this. Blend that in, give it that misty look. That misty level. Pull up. Blend it. That illusion. I think what we'll do is we'll make this one a little higher. A little thicker. be a little less gap in between. Maybe it's a little fuller too. A little more woodsy. Layers going on there. Give that area kind of blend it in more. In between the two. Filled it in better. There's a little bit too much of a white gappy in between there. Now you can see the levels. Okay, now we can come in. We'll bring in some landscaping. Bit of green and brown, darken it, darker color, and we'll come right in here and put the land in. Tap it in, make it a little darker. make it a little hilly. Not so straight. More land, more hills. I'm going to come down here and put some of that reflection in the water. Clean off that fan brush. Come into some white. That off again, come into some just whites. Go right along the horizon here. Just tapping this in for right now. And we'll get the blender brush going. That soft blender brush. Tap this all the way across. Blend it all in right like that. Kind of like that. Kind of like that's doing right there. Get some brown. Load it up. Come right in here and we'll tap. Right along that edge. Right along. such. And we'll come in and we'll pull this down. Just with the edge. Bringing down some of that green, the browns, the reflection. Maybe down here there'll be more. Maybe here there'll be more. Since it's darker over in this area. Line there. A little roll of paint. Just tapping it. Kind of breaks that up right away. Gives you that look. Maybe more over here. Looks pretty good to me. Okay, we got that going on. I think we can put some lighter clouds up there. lighter pinks, I think, would be good. Underbrush, blending it in. Getting that cloud. Back. I think this might be a little bit too dark. Can have some dark in there, but most part, let's keep it. Let's keep it just like that. It's pretty good to me. Evergreen trees in. I think we'll use this fan brush, the big one. Come into some browns, dark brown. Have it come right across here. All the way down. And who knows, maybe there's something else over here. We'll have some trees. In the middle there. Tapping this in. Get all kinds of little things happening. blender brush and blend this in. Blend that in. Maybe to make that a little lighter in there. Just like that. With that abstract look. Different things going on. Take the blender brush and tap this in. That up, get it underneath there. That's some clean that fan brush off again. Into some lighter colors. Maybe down in here. Maybe right down in the middle. Get all blended in. See what kind of look we got going on there with the blender brush. Different things going on. Different light areas in through here. Can even make it lighter. Can you even make it lighter right in through there? Back in with the blender brush. Different layers you can put in. Different lightnesses. Back. I think I like a little bit more weight. A little bit more weight right in there. Just tapping it. some evergreen trees in here. Can you even come in with some pink? Pinkish color. See if we got a little bit more alizarin crimson. That's the pink color that we were using. Clean off that fan brush. Come into some whites and that purple, pink, crimson. Just a little bit to flavor it. Clean that blender brush off. Come in and just tap that. Brings that through. Now, let's put some evergreen trees in. Evergreen trees. Using sap green, browns, blacks, midnight black, liquid clear. Loaded right up, just like that. Okay, we'll come in and who knows, maybe we'll have some back here first. One. head on the side of the cliff. There might be one over here. Doing is pushing up. Pushing up on where I think. The branches should be. And you can do the same thing. Just kind of look at it. Yep, that's where I like it. Get some darker color going. Three there. I think we'll put a big one right here. A nice evergreen tree. Put another one right here. Maybe we can have one here. kind of like that, just like that. Put some darker ones in. Filling it in. This can be the first snowfall. We have some snow in here. Coming right down the mountain. Snow. A little bit of snow. A little bit of snowfall. Come in and we'll tap in this. Let's set right down in there. The blender brush. That snow. A bit of snow. Now we'll come into this little brush here and we'll get some twigs and little grassy areas coming through. Load it right up. I've come to a point. So. Grassy areas there going. Some there. Who knows? Maybe some stuff coming out here. Like that, a little bit of snow coming down. Just like that. And on that note, I think we're going to say this one is completed. Here in the bottom corner. Make it a little darker. I like signing mine with my last name. Some people like to use their initials. I also like putting the year in. Let you know what you were thinking at the time, your progression. I hope you enjoyed this one. Something a little bit different. Got some snow coming in. I hope you come back and see me.